Welcome to a Delco Nerd Network podcast. I am your host, Anthony Rigucci, and this is Replay, Relive, and Re-Experience, or as we like to call it, Re3, is where, you guessed it, we do all three of those things to our favorite video game franchises. In this edition of Re3, we'll be replaying, reliving, and re-experiencing the Halo franchise, starting with Halo Combat Evolved and ending with Halo 5 Guardians, in anticipation for Halo Infinite this December. In anticipation for Halo Infinite this December. Here to go on Master Chief Saga with me, as always, the triple threat, Chris Trio, who is not here for yet another episode. But of course, our second co-host, Delaware County's own Chris Geddes. Welcome back to this fucking hellhole we call Reach.
Hell yeah.
Yeah. Hell again, yeah. It's getting bad to fucking worse.
I don't know, man. I don't know if they can do it.
We'll see. Episode 26. Let's do it. Exodus, New Alexandria. Exodus is the 7th campaign level of Halo Reach. Here, 6 will help citizens of New Alexandria escape the Covenant.
Noble 6, alone on a snowy landscape, holding his left arm, regains mobility. 6 slowly walks back to the re-entry unit to acquire a pistol. 6 then looks up at the remains of the Long Night of Solace, crashed on a distant mountain range. 6 begins walking away from the wreck with a noticeable limp. 6, now in a more temperate landscape, jogs closer to a cliff, stops at the top, and New Alexandria, with 3 Covenant Corvettes over it, comes into view. Explosions fill the sky, and the sound of intense combat is heard in the distance. New Alexandria, Ipaz, August 23rd, 2552,
1534. So, hold on, let's go back to that last date. It's been like five days.
I thought it was the Saber program was the 14th. And this is...
It's been like 9 days.
Oh my God.
How the hell has it been 9 days? That's like...
What has he been doing?
Do you think he just like crashed and like fucking like chilled out for like a few days? Or maybe he had to walk to New Alexandria. One thing I would say, the cutscenes are epic, but like when he gets the gun and then it cuts to black and then he like comes up on the city. I'm like...
How long was he walking? If that's...
Right. And then, but like, I don't like that jump cut. It looks like you're like 12 years old and you're filming your own movie and like you like do a cut and like you're just randomly somewhere else and you like look back at the camera and you start like running. Like, that's what that scene reminded me of. And I was just like, all right, that was like a weird cut.
Yeah.
They should have showed him walking.
Yeah.
Like he actually had some like distance to go. But again, like we get over that the view of New Mombasa and like shit is just going to hell. Like the whole city is being invaded. Like, again, that sense of dread that I think Reach tries to like instill, like from tip of the spear on, I think you're getting that, because again, like at certain parts of the level you just feel like it's like it is just going bad to worse. What do you think?
I didn't even know. I never noticed that it was like a 9 day jump cut. That's so strange.
Yeah, it's gotta be the walk.
Yeah,
it has to be.
It really throws me off, because yeah, it's gotta be. And I mean, the limp is better, obviously, towards that last cutscene before he jumps into the city there. Obviously, he doesn't have a limp anymore.
Yeah.
So, how was he healing? How did he, like, did he just lay low for a while and nurse his wound? That's, yeah. What did he eat? Grass? Dirt?
Did he take his helmet off? Who knows?
We'll never know. 6 lets George's dog tags slip slightly from their hand and places them in a chest pouch, skips to a building rooftop on the city outskirts. 6, still holding the pistol, creeps beside the edge, jumps down, and staggers slightly on their leg. They walk past plasma scarring on the wall and ready the pistol. They jump down again onto a walkway.
So, once we make our way into the city, we'll see a plethora of mutilated civilians strewn about the walkway. Like they're just being fucking massacred.
Yeah.
Stagger is one of the Marines here in New Alexandria, so I guess he boards the Pillar of Autumn at some point.
I would assume so.
Not that we really ever see that, technically. There's a lot of comm chatter in this level that I kind of just show. It's just like a lot of flavor text kind of stuff. But it definitely suggests that UNSC is not doing hot.
Oh, yeah.
Like, I think they're one of the first dialogues is between Stacker and like another comm dude, and they're talking about like destroying the Corvette, and they just can't kill it.
Yeah,
and the Stacker's like, "How do you stop that thing?" we'll move forward a little bit and we'll see some brutes torturing civilians. Not the first time we've seen this in Halo. We see it a lot in Halo 3.
Oh, yeah.
Where they hold up the Marines and they fuck them up. So, again, before we go into the redesign, it's definitely interesting to see, like, the difference between the elites fighting and the difference between the brutes fighting.
Yeah.
Like, I think the brutes or the elites will, like, definitely kill civilians. Like, they actually... No, they do it. They do it in Reach. But, like, it's not as... It doesn't seem to be as, like...
Enjoyable?
Or, like, gratuitous. Like, yeah. They do it for, like, out of necessity, not out of, like, pleasure.
Yeah.
But the brutes are just fucking people up because they like to do it.
Yep.
And we see a little bit of a redesign here. Not necessarily with the higher ranks, but, like, the lower ranks don't have as much armor. Like, they... And, like, no fur.
Yeah. Yep. I noticed that.
Yeah. And then the Spiker gets a redesign, which I kind of like. It's, like, a little bigger and heftier, and it kind of is more, like, rifle-looking, whereas, like, the Spiker, I thought in Halo 3, was more SMG-ish-like. Like. Eventually, we'll get to the Praxis Tower, where we are basically going to evac and help support the other evac troops. We get to the tower, defend the elevator, as Stacker sends it down. Any kind of thoughts, inputs while we're just doing this combat scenario?
Not more so this, but I've noticed a lot of the levels are just multiplayer maps or like firefight maps.
Yeah, that is that's like really apparent in Reach.
Yeah.
I mean ODST I guess kind of had those sections too, but like I guess Halo 2 and 3 weren't necessarily like as egregious about it. And I mean there's that one sword based level with the like the bridges and like the Oni the Oni building was a multiplayer map. Anything else?
Not really. Did they address Stacker by name?
No, but it's definitely just the voice actor.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
it's definitely him. It has to be him.
Yeah.
Because he's in Halo 1. Mm-hmm. So he would definitely be on Reach.
Makes sense.
Or like, the wiki says it's Stacker.
Okay.
It has to be. Yeah. And I was just like, it wouldn't make sense if it wasn't him.
Mm-hmm.
But I think I remember we talked about that his voice actor appeared somewhere where like, I was like.
Wasn't it in ODST? During like one of like Mickey or
I think it was, but I'm trying to think. I guess Stacker would have been on New Mombasa, like with Chips Dubbo.
Them too.
But like, where do they? Yeah, it's and you have no timeline for when they actually leave.
Yeah, nothing on the wiki.
Or I guess no, they maybe probably would have never left. Because they come back.
Yeah,
and they're still in the same area. They probably never left. They're probably there the whole time. And Johnson comes back. We're kind of getting off track here. But yeah, I guess those Marines never leave Earth.
I think you're right.
Because I guess it's a few days and they find Chief in the woods and they regroup with Johnson. Yeah, I guess that makes sense. There's your Stacker timeline for you. We get in the elevator. We join a team of ODSTs who call themselves the Bullfrogs. As we jump. As we get our jetpack and we jetpack essentially from like one part of the building to another. And then we get on to our Falcon and we evac out of there.
Evac transport, Delta 1-5 to evac dispatch. Loaded up, ready to go.
Delta 1-5, this is evac dispatch. Copy that. Proceed at your discretion.
Midtown airspace is way too hot. Gonna take an alternate route. Delta 1-5 to dispatch. Banshee squadron on my tail. Taking fire.
Copy, Delta 1-5. Can you?
Mayday! Port engines hit. We're going in. I'm going to try to set her down.
Fox Actual to UNSC frigate Starward Dawn. Request immediate airstrike on Covenant Corvette over Starport.
Solid copy, Fox Actual. Longswords are unavailable at this time. Over.
This is civilian transport 6 Echo 2. I need to go now, Sergeant Major. Hold on, Echo 2. Starward Dawn. I have multiple personnel craft loaded with civilians. I have to get them out of this city. I need air support now.
As soon as something frees up, you'll be the first to.
Not good enough. I've got 600 souls on board, Sergeant Major. I can't wait any longer. Negative, Echo 2. I can't cover you. Do not take off. Damn it. It's pretty crazy. Like, imagine you're fucking flying a plane with 600 people on it, and like you're just like, I gotta leave.
Well, they're all like parked on the, I don't know if it's like a land.
Like a runway.
Yeah, like a runway.
Yeah, because I guess they're planes, they don't need a lot of room to take off, so they just go up and fly. Yeah, you can kind of see it as you pass. And
Yeah,
but like, again, like crazy sort of like, what am I trying to say? tone setting with like these, like everyone is freaking the fuck out. Like you can, they have it together, but at the same time, like they're all scared.
Yeah.
Like the civilian people, the Marines, like there's just like, they don't have their shit together. They can't get everyone out of here. Like if they take off, they're going to get shot down, which does happen. Mm-hmm. As the Falcon gets closer to the starport, they notice 6X02 taking off, even though they just told them not to. The Corvette over the starport instantly fires on the transport, hits it. To the port with a side, hits it on the port side with a plasma torpedo, crippling the craft.
Oh my God!
Mayday, mayday! Six Echo Two, can you maintain altitude? Negative, we're going down!
Son of a bitch, I can't watch this!
The transport crashes into the harbor and slowly sinks. We arm, so yeah, we'll basically land on a beach, we'll talk to that Sergeant Duval guy, and he tells us we need to arm 2 missile batteries and fire the missiles at the corvettes, which we do.
Six walks to an open area as the 3 transports speeds over him and into space.
You'll copy. Repeat, this is Noble 2. Noble 6. Noble 5, do you copy?
This is 6. Go ahead, Noble 2.
We picked up your transponder about an hour ago, but could not risk open comps. Covenant, have this city sealed tight. We're getting nothing from George.
He didn't make it.
Understood. What's the situation at the starport exit?
The last transport is away.
All right, we're bringing you to us.
Six throws a signal flare onto the ground. Six walks away as the view zooms out and shows the damaged Corvette retreating from the city.
Yeah, man. We kind of like brushed by George's death a little bit.
Yeah, but I mean, I was like, going to bring that up, but we ended it.
No, I mean, we can talk about it now. He's probably just got
He's one of my favorite characters probably in the game.
Just, yeah.
He's tall man, let me tell you. Yeah. What a man.
Yeah, I mean, like, he has a very, like, Spartan 2-y personality, I guess. Like, you know, like, Reach was good to me. Like, very, very, like, reverent towards the planet, and it's, I guess, what it's done for him. Yeah, and like, there's really no, there's really no hesitation in that scene. Like, he, like, makes that decision, and he knows.
Split second.
Right. Like, you know, and, like, you do kind of move past that death relatively quickly.
Yeah.
Like, the game doesn't really linger on it, but with Kat, spoilers in the next level, it's kind of different. Yeah. They do linger on her death a little bit more because it is so sudden.
It's unreal how sudden it is.
I thought that was, I remember when that first happened, and I was like when I first played the game, and I was like, holy shit. Like, it's like she's mid-sentence sprinting with you guys talking, and like she's a talker.
She's cut off mid-sentence.
It's like, again, this is Reach. All these Spartans die. We know this. So like in a way, it's kind of like The Walking Dead. It's like it's like at a certain point, like deaths are going to come from like any which way, and like a character you like is going to be gone in an instant. It is kind of funny. It's like June, like, doesn't even count as the squad half the time. He's really, like, there, but not. But, like, you know, after this level, we're down to, like, 3 major players. I mean, June gets out of here. We know that.
And dips.
It's Emil, Carter, and Six.
Six.
But let's move on to New Alexandria.
This is the 8th campaign level of Halo Reach. This level has a unique structure. The 3 main objectives may be assigned to the player in any order, and the minor objectives between these are randomly selected from a larger pool every time the mission is played. I did not know that.
I didn't know that either, because I didn't get Buck's mission in this playthrough.
I got it on Legendary when I was playing with
friends. And I was like, did I miss it? And then I went to put the doc together, and I'm like, oh, shit. I don't even think I knew the main objectives were in a different order. I'm like, that's interesting. I wonder why they chose to do that. Why they chose to, like, think about it. In this game, we had our first, like, dogfight kind of level, and in this game we have like an open world ish
it's like RNG, honestly.
Like you get random missions. Like, it is kind of cool. They could have just made all 3 of the missions in the same order, and you do all little side things in between, and they're all the same every time, but they didn't choose to do that. Bungie kind of took a different approach at it. Just finishing off what Chris was saying, the mission requires the player to fly a Falcon, and the player is able to call in a new one if they lose theirs.
This mission is brutal on Legendary.
Trying to remember. I don't remember having that much of an issue.
Because you can either get a Falcon with a machine gun or the grenade launcher one. And if you have the machine gun, you're
fine. Wait, really?
Yeah, there's 2 different Falcons.
I don't even think I realized that.
Really?
No, yeah.
I just remember from playing on Legendary, my buddy got the...
Is the one that's...
The one at the start, I think, is the GL one.
So... Does the grenade launcher one shoot in bursts or no?
Nope. It's just like there was another segment where you were on the
Not tip of the spear.
Oh, you mean if the Marines...
Yes.
Those guns.
Yes.
Gotcha.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, that's fucking stupid. Oh my God. Yeah, they're just like shooting lobbing grenades and like not hitting a thing. Yeah, okay.
View switches to the open rear door of the Pelican. Burning skyscrapers and buildings light fill the sky. After staring out for a long time, Six stands up and holsters a DMR. The Pelican slows down above a rooftop with two Falcons parked on top. Six steps out and meets Carter while the Pelican flies away. Your report will have to wait, Lieutenant. The Covenant are jamming all comms to command. Cat needs your help running a counter-op.
The two Spartans walk to the Falcons with one already taking off.
It's good to have you back.
Sorry I came alone.
Make him proud.
Carter turns and slowly walks away from Six in front of the Falcon. Cat will direct us to three locations, a hospital, a club, and an office building to turn off the con jammers. There are a lot of Easter eggs in this level, too. The club has one.
Yep. That's a good one.
Yeah, so if I remember it right, because I did it, there's like a button on the side of a building that you have to hit, and then it turns like the club on, and like all the grunts and hunters and start dancing.
Yeah, and the brutes are all in there partying.
Yeah, when you shut off the jammer, do they not get knocked out of it, or are they always in it?
Yeah, oh yeah.
Yeah. The hospital, I like the locations in this level, I actually have to admit. The hospital's the... the office building is the multiplayer level, which I don't really like. It doesn't really, like... It's the only one I'm like, I like what it looks like, but I feel like the way the level's laid out is just like, this is just a little too copy-paste for me. But the hospital and the club, I like. They're pretty enjoyable. In between these missions, we'll receive extra secondary missions to destroy banshees, turrets, hunters, and one of them, and there's more than that, there's actually a lot. One of them is you help a group of ODSTs led by Buck, who we know escaped from New Alexandria because of this.
Interesting that it's like a random chance to get that.
Yeah.
I feel like that should be permanently in just to kind of, you know, three and or ODST and Reach kind of bridge those two stories together and keep
in the
war
in the office building. The freaking out Marine is in this. I chose not to put in his dialogue because it's not really, it's more an Easter egg in this one.
Yeah.
Where some of the others, it is kind of like story. I think this is the first one that isn't really story essential in two and three and in one. It's all kind of like...
One with the flood, yeah.
Yeah. I'm trying to think of what it is in two. In ODST, it's that the zoo guy.
Mm-hmm.
What's it in two? Unless twos is an Easter egg.
I don't know.
I don't remember. Yeah, but this is like, you know, he's just like freaking out, essentially. So after we're done shutting off the comms, we have to return, or we have to go to ONI HQ to regroup with our squad.
Inside the Olympic Tower, Noble Six joins up with the rest of Noble Team. The glass windows are shattered, and a crashed Banshee can be seen tangled up in some cables. Cat is fixing a comm unit with her helmet on the floor. June looks out with a pair of binoculars. Emil sits at the side, sharpening his kukri, and Carter stands against the far wall by the Banshee.
Look at this place. Used to be the crown jewel. Not anymore. Turns and notices Six. Hey, you made it.
It's a regular family reunion.
Six looks at him and loosens his or her hand to show George's dog tags dangling from it.
Keep him. He gave him to you. Pointed himself with a kukri. I'll honor him my own way.
George always said he would never leave Reach.
The big man was sentimental. He gave his life thinking he just saved the planet. We should all be so lucky.
Carter walks towards the window besides June. Sir, that true about the gauntlet? Red and Echo teams assigned to civilian evac troops?
Carter turns to Kat, knowing she is responsible for the leak.
Those are senior-level how do you say that?
Communiques, I think it is.
Communiques?
Yeah, so those teams that June is talking about, Echo and Gauntlet are just made up for this game, and Red is actually from Halo Wars, but it's nothing too crazy lore intense that's like, oh, it's Master Chief and Lisa, or is it Lisa? Linda.
Linda, yeah.
It's Master Chief and Linda? No.
Those are senior-level communiques.
I hear what I hear. Point is, why put Spartan on defense deployments?
I need that link to SATCOM, Cap.
Chasing it, but this console has more shrapnel than transceivers. You didn't answer my question.
You want to know if we're losing?
I know we're losing. I want to know if we've lost.
Carter looks out to the city when beeping and static from the comms break silence.
Colonel Holland hailing us. What's he doing on an open channel?
Let's hear it.
Near the southwest quarter of the city, over Sierra 259. If you are receiving, I'm authorized override of security of radio security protocols to link with this channel.
How long for a secure link?
I can't guarantee secure anymore.
Could the Covenant trace it to us?
I could. Noble leader, this is Priority One Hale. If you're receiving, acknowledge immediately.
Cat hands Carter the communicator's earpiece.
Keep it brief.
Carter here. Yes, sir. Carter walks towards the window as June notices something through his binoculars and leans forward.
We've got movement. Multiple Covenant vehicles vacating the area. And they are in a hurry.
How often you see Covenant retreat for no reason?
Radiation flare! Big! 40 million...
Rodkins?
Rodkins, that's what she says. Yeah, thank you.
Just lost Holland. What's going on?
Atomic excitement scrambled the signal. 90 million now.
Source?
Airborne, close.
How close?
Covenant ships begin glassing nearby area, creating a large shockwave. Noble team members stand up and are thrown to the ground as the explosion destroys the windows and pressure waves force the air into the building. Switch to Cat's view.
That close.
Spartans get to their feet and Cat picks up her helmet. They run towards two elevators. Carter, Emil, and June take one while Cat and Noble Six take the other. Cat closes the elevator door and starts it, though she misses the button at first, having been partially blinded by the explosion. The elevators rush down the building as Cat puts her helmet on.
First glassing. Me too. Don't worry. I'm on it. Our best option is a fallout bunker in sub-level 2. 96 meters northwest. We get orders from Holland, sir?
We're being redeployed to Sword Base.
Sword? Sword! Covenant own it now!
Which is why they want us for a torch and burn op. Keep Dr. Halsey's excavation data from falling into enemy hands.
Carter's elevator stops and the first three Spartans rush out. If it hasn't already... Six and Cat rush out of their elevator as the other three approach the bunker's entrance.
Maybe, but according to Holland, the Covenant are still hunting for something.
Carter, June, and Emil reach the bunker's entrance with Six and Cat close behind.
Where does he get off calling a demolition up priority one?
Cat's sentence is cut off as a needle rifle round pierces her helmet from above, leaving a hole in her faceplate. Cat falls to the floor, killed instantly.
Brutal,
Six
man.
Catches her and holds her body, takes her holstered pistol and begins to shoot at the field marshal and the previously unnoticed Phantom above them. The others come to assist with assault rifles, but the Phantom flies away. Six throws the emptied pistol and drags Cat's body into the bunker.
Come on, get in!
Let's go, come on!
Six rests Cat's body on the floor and the bunker door closes. We fade to black. August 26, 2552, 300 hours. Fades into Noble Teed, led by June, walking out to the destroyed glass city. Cat's body is cradled in Carter's arms. June throws a signal flare to the ground and waves as a pelican slowly comes into view. That is our level. Yeah, so again, we kind of like linger on Cat's death is so much more like, it kind of like rocks the squad. And I feel like the way it's shot and the way they did that scene is kind of like, okay, like it's getting serious. Like two squad mates just died like two levels in a row.
I feel like they would have, obviously, I feel like they would have lingered on George's death more. Granted, if he was like, happened in the same way or around the same time as Kat, but damn dude, they really just,
and it's funny how like they know they're losing and like she's like people are fucking leaving, like we're, like Reach is done.
Yeah,
like it if it didn't seem obvious before, it's like now the character, like you may be saying it, but now the characters are like, is this, are we losing here? And it's kind of, I wish we had some context to like kind of how the war actually goes. Like I guess I wouldn't assume that the humans are losing necessarily, but like we're kind of told that a few times, but it never really seems like, oh, like the UNSC are like getting their asses handed to them.
Yeah.
But Reach really seems to be, it's like almost a turning point, but Master Chief like just happens to like just fucking save the fucking day.
Thank God.
With like the discovery of like the Halo ring, and like I feel like that itself really just changes the war.
Mm-hmm.
Because then the Covenant find it and then they just get kind of like distracted by it. It's like, oh, like they were chasing the humans there.
Yeah.
They got there and they were just like, it's a fucking Halo ring. Like,
what's this?
Right. Now we're going to unleash the flood.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So before we wrap up, Chris, any sort of closing comments for New Alexandria and Exodus?
New Alexandria was a really good level. These levels were really good. I actually really liked them. Maybe it was like the setting, like being in the city,
yeah,
and stuff like that.
Yeah, I liked kind of being in the city, seeing like not only the Marines in the city, but like the civilians running around. Again, mm-hmm. It kind of feels more lived in. It feels more real. Like, because we get some civilians in 3, but we're not really seeing like a ton of civilians ever.
Yeah,
in Halo, it's just like they're not. They wouldn't be there. So it's kind of a cool change of pace. There's actually some sense of urgency mm-hmm. in the world around you.
At the beginning of Exodus, I wound up tossing a grenade at a brute, killed a civilian.
And you just die.
Put me right to the start of the level. I restarted.
Really?
Yeah. It was early, like when the brutes first showed up.
Maybe there's no checkpoints up until
probably
that
not.
Because there's no enemies.
Yeah. Because I was walking around and I was like, oh, I just talked to a random
Yeah, if
friend.
You... it was funny. In the first level, I didn't put it in the dock because I didn't really find it necessary. Mm-hmm. I like remember how like the family's like in that house and like the dad opens the door and I think there's like 2 people behind him. Yeah. I like shot one of them and just like instantly died. And I was like, oh, like I don't think I remember it doing that, but that's
interesting. It killed you? Like it put you right to?
It didn't put me. It put me at the checkpoint.
Gotcha.
Yeah. Anything else?
No, not really.
Well. If that is it, that wraps it up for another episode of Halo Re3. Guys, thank you for listening either on YouTube.com or one of the many podcast services we're on. To find us, just search Delco Nerd Network. You can follow us on Instagram and Twitter at Delco Nerds. Find us on Facebook if you search Facebook.com/Delco Nerd Network. Please join our Discord. We have all sorts of conversations about whatever the fuck's going on in the news. I'm trying to Trio has this like form down where he just like says shit, but like, and I always fall into it and then I do this kind of thing, so I'm not. Just join the Discord. It's a bunch of fun. You can find all this information at www.delconerdnetwork.com. We also have an email. You can shoot us delconerds@gmail.com. Guys, thank you for listening. We'll see you next time. Stay nerdy.